So this is heap. So today's topic is heap. Heap plays the fourth major topic of second unit. So as far as the title of the second unit is concerned, it is hierarchical tree data structure. So what are the topics that we have covered so far is binary search tree, B-tree, red-black tree, and this heap. So under heap you have three varieties: binary heap, binomial heap, and a Fibonacci heap. So that's what we are going to see in this session. So as usual, I am going to give a summary about these various topics. One with the help of my presentation, another with the help of my web resources chosen from Geeks for Geeks. Right. First of all, you should know what is a heap. So by the definition, it says that a heap is a certain kind of complete binary tree. Students, you know very well about what is a binary tree and what is a complete binary tree. In the initial class itself, I have taken the idea about binary tree as well as complete binary tree. See, if all the levels are filled, that is, binary tree means root node, left side, right side. And for that left side parent, left side, right side, and for that right side parent, left side, right side, and then it goes. If all the levels are completely filled without any omission, then it is a full binary tree. If there is any omission with respect to the levels, then it is said to be a complete binary tree. So what is the heap? It is said as a complete binary tree, but the additional word that is given is a certain kind of complete binary tree. So that's what we are going to see. What is that certain kind of binary tree? Complete binary tree. So in general, when you are going to construct a complete binary tree or a binary tree or whatever full binary tree, usually you should start with the root node. After root node, the next node that you should create is left child. Then followed by that is right child. Then followed by that, you should fill the next level, that is the left child's left node as well as the right node, and for the right child parent, left child node and right side node. Likewise, it goes by filling the node at every level. See, look at it. Now the tree is not a complete binary tree. Now the tree is a full binary tree because all the levels are completely filled. What is the level 0? It is the root node. What is level 1? That is the second level. It has two childs, left and right. What is level 2? It is the last level. It has four leaf nodes, left and right for one left child parent and left and right for another right child parent of the root node. So this is complete. This is a full binary tree because all the levels are filled completely. But when you add one more level, when you add one more level, and if you left other nodes, say for example, here you have here you have a node. See, this is a level 0. And this is level 1, and this is level 2, and this is level 3. So in the level 3, you have nodes, and if you look at the nodes have been filled. The nodes have been filled from left to right. And if you leave this tree as such, because without filling these portion, these positions, then it is going to be a complete binary tree. Then it is going to be complete binary tree. So in case, if you fill this level, left, right, so here also you have left right, and here also you have left right, and here also you have left right, and here also you have left right. So likewise, if you fill all the levels, then what is the thing that you have to be think in mind is you should have a definition for full binary tree. But this is not a full binary tree because it is a complete binary tree. So what is heap? It is a complete binary tree, but it has a certain kind. So what is that certain kind is? First, so far we have discussed about the structure. Now we are going to discuss about the data arrangement. So regarding data arrangement, see, that is called certain kind. So now the keyword certain is highlighted. So what is that certain kind? If you look at the values, what is the value? Root has 45. Its left child has 35. right side has 23, 35 left side has 27, right side 21. It's like this. If you look at the values, one style or one possible arrangement you can understand. What is that possible arrangement is? If you take a key value of any particular node, it should be less than or equal to its root or greater than or equal to its child. Right? So 45 is greater than 35, whereas the 27 and 21 are lesser than the 35. When you take 35 and 23, these two are child and these two childs are lesser than the parent. When you take 22 and 24, these two are child and that child is lesser than the 23. So likewise, each node in a heap contains a key that can be compared to other nodes' key. That can be. So what kind of comparison is possible? So that's what I said. If you take the case of root node, the root node key value should be greater than or equal to its child. If you take the value of the child node, the value of the child node should be less than or equal to its parent. So that's the certain property. And this property is called as heap property. This property. So yeah, heap is a certain kind of complete binary tree. That means it has a property, that is property is called heap property. So that's the property. Is the node key value is greater than or equal to is key's children. Now when you want to add an element to this key, say for example, now I am going to add element 42. What you have to do is you have to check the 42 with the now the 42 is added at the next immediate node that is possible in the complete binary tree as well as in the last level. Now if you compare the node value 42 with the 27, which is greater, 42 is greater. So what is the thing you have to do is you have to do a comparison you have to do a comparison with the 42. And you have to put this 42 in the next, that is previous level. That is, you need to do a comparison between 27 and 42 and you do a swap. That means while doing a swap, the 42 is moving upward. The 42 is moving upward. Next, what you have to do, you have to compare the 42 and the 35. If the 42 is greater, then you should do to move upward. Now you should compare 42 with 45. If that 42 is greater, then you should move upward. Otherwise, you keep as such. So this is the way of moving the node. So in what way you are moving, it should be greater than or equal to. So you have to find a place where this 42 holds the property of the heap that is greater than or equal to its child. So now the 42 is greater than or equal to its child. So this is the way. But the process of swapping the node value from downside, that is leaf side, to upward side is known to called reheapification upward, the pushing the new node upward. This is called reheapification upward. See, remember, so this process is called reheapification upward. Likewise, when you want to remove an element, how to delete an element from the heap? So when you want to remove an element, first of all, what you have to do, this element is removed, right? This element is removed. So after removing this element, you should keep the topmost element to this level. Then you should need to bring it back, right? So the 45 is deleted, and that node is moved from that position to 27 is moved because 45 is a root node is deleted. So root node is deleted. Then this 27 is moved there. So now you need to check with the 27 with the next other possible values, 42. So 42 is compared with the 27. When this node is compared, so what you can find is 27 is lesser than 42. So we can do a swap. So while you are going to do a swap, so you need to bring that node downward. When you are bringing that node downward, what the thing happens? 42 goes upward and 27 come upward, come downward. Then you should compare 27 and 35. If you compare 27 and 35, so what you can infer, 27 is lesser, so you have to come down, you have to bring it down. So 35 goes upward, right? Now if you compare 27 and 19, what you can infer, 27 is greater than or equal to its child, so you keep the 27 as such. So what is carried out in this throughout the process? So first of all, the 45 is deleted in that place. 27 is pushed, and you should find a new position for this 27, whether it should be in the 42nd position, whether it should be in the 35th position or not. So for that, you should bring down, that is move downward, That is, this process is going to be called reheapification downward. Reheapification, the process of pushing the new node in the reheapification downward. So on the whole summary, if I want to say what is a heap is, a heap is a complete binary tree. What is that certain kind? Where entry at each node is greater than or equal to the entries in each children. That is called certain kind of binary tree. So if you want to add an element in element into a heap, you should place the new element in the next possible location, and then you have to check that position is possible according to the heap property or not. When you are going to satisfy the heap property, you should move the node upward, and that process is called reheapification upward. Similarly, when you want to remove any node, just you remove the biggest node, because this is the property, you cannot remove any element as such. You should move the biggest node, and in that biggest node position, you should bring the last leaf node to that location. And then you should find a new position by moving downward, So if you are moving downward by one level down, then you may find a reheapification downward, reheapification of that process. So that's what the idea is all about. Students, I hope you understand the idea. Is it okay with the heap, what I'm telling?
Do you have yes, any sir. Doubt? No doubt, sir.
Okay. So this is called a heap, and this heap can be divided into two kinds, min heap and max heap. So when is min heap, you can say that as, see, this element is max heap because the root element is having, So the root element is having the maximum maximum element, and the other elements are minimum. So this is the min heap. Likewise, if the root element is having minimum, all the other elements are maximum. That is called max heap. So you have two different kinds of heap, min heap and max heap. And of course, you may find that a kind of sorting algorithm is possible with the help of the heap, and that heap is called a heap sort. And you can implement a priority queue using the heap. Now, what I am going to do is, I am going to teach you some web resources in order to understand what is the various kinds of heap. So, in general, there are three different kinds of heap. So, what are those heap are? So, as per our syllabus is expecting us to study Fibonacci heap. But before Fibonacci heap, you should thorough with binary heap and binomial heap. So, what is binary heap? That's the heap that I have discussed so far. So, the heap that I have discussed so far using the PowerPoint presentation is the binary heap. So, what is this binary heap? Let me summarize once again with a web resource. Why I am teaching you the web resources, that's only you can also go beyond your textbook and you seek the web resources. Because our exam pattern is like MCQ, and we are told to cover the syllabus by 80% or 75% through the lecture, and 30% or 25% by means of the students, those who have themselves go and refer some materials. So that is called a flipped classroom strategy. So that's why I introduced you to go through the web resource material also. You don't stick onto the syllabus, but you stick onto some material related to the syllabus. So what is binary heap? So by the name itself, it is mentioned that a binary heap is a binary tree with the following properties. So that's the property that I have explained so far. It should be a complete binary tree, and how that complete binary tree will make the tree arrangements, that is a node arrangement. So it can be called by two names, max min heap, max heap. See, if you could see, so this is a min heap, min heap. So 10, 20, 100, 30. So every so root is minimum element and every other elements are maximum element. Likewise, root is minimum element and every other. So this is the example for here, if you want to go for representation, I'm not talking about the representation in the PowerPoint slide. Just I'm talking about how the inserts and deletions are happened out. So if you want to do the representation, what you can do is how the next element is stored or how to retrieve the elements. So how the array position and array index value is retrieved. So array of I minus 1 divided by 2, array of 2i plus 1, array of 2i plus 2, like that. You have to return the element and you have to return the parent and the left child, right child, according to that way in which it is presented. So this is the way the heap sort is working. This is 1, 3, 2, 6, like that. So heap sort. So this is called level order. So yeah, by level the elements are ordered, then only it is possible for making. So when you are having, when you are provided with some list of elements, what you can do is you can construct a heap using the list of elements. Then what you can do is you can remove the elements, that is delete the elements. While you are deleting the elements, what you can do is you can move this 8 by pushing, deleting the 1, so 1 comes here. Then you have to find the suitable position for 8. Then you have to delete the next smallest 3. Then you have to push that element. Like this, if you do the deletion according to the heap property, then you may find a heap shot. This is what binary heap. So what is the application of binary heap? Binary heap is having wonderful application. Heap shot, priority queue, Dijkstra algorithm, Prim's algorithm, and another major examples like largest element, finding the largest element, sorting, merging. What are the operations that you can do? So you can get the minimum element and you can extract the minimum element. You can decrease the key value. So there are many other possible operations that you can do with the help of min heap. Insert, delete is the common operation that I have illustrated using the slide. So this is what binary heap. Binary heap is the simple heap. And what about binomial heap? So what about binomial heap is, if you look at the material, so the binomial heap is also a binary heap, but it provides a little extension. What is the extension that we will see later? But why this extension is? This extension is to make the union as well as merge operation very faster. If you look at Z, it provides a faster union and merge operation. So it is 80% binary heap with the additional extension that makes the union and merge operation faster. What makes this merge operation as well as union operation faster means? So you should remember, or you should think about a binomial tree of order 0. That means one node tree. Even if you have a binomial tree of order k, then it's also be constructed using a binomial trees, two different binomials of order k minus 1, and making one as a left child of the other. Like that you can combine. So a binomial tree is to be created with the following properties. If that binomial tree is said to be of order k, then it should have 2 to the power k nodes. Say for example, if you are going to consider a binomial tree of order 3, then how many nodes it should have? 2 to the power 3, 8 nodes it should have. And how the depth is calculated? Depth, I already told, depth is calculated from the root node 2. So k equal to 3 means 3 depths, 3 depths. And how many combinations of nodes kci? That is the combination, permutation combination, so that kind of node is there. Say for example, if you have k equal to 0, then you have single node. K equal to 1 means you have one node in the root as one node in the left. If k you have 5 equal to 2, then you have 2 nodes, because k equal to means 2 to the power k, 4 nodes. So 0, 1, 2, 3. If you have k equal to 8, 0, sorry, root, left, middle, right. So like that it goes, like that it goes when you go for it. So this is what a binomial tree is all about. See, binomial tree. See, it is not a binary tree, but it is a binary. If it is a binary tree, this middle element is not available, right? Middle element. So see, how many branches are there? 3 branches are there. So look at it. This is single, this is double, this is left to right. See, look at it. How many nodes are there? Your direct connection, 1 node, 2 node, 3 nodes. There are 3 nodes are there. There are 3 branches are there. So each and every subtree. So these subtrees are connected with a single key element. This is called binomial tree. So when you go for binomial tree, when compared with the binary tree, it doesn't have 2 branches. It does have more than 1 branches, and it follows a certain property, and that property is based on this binomial tree. Binomial tree. So this is the way in which you can consider. So this is one tree. This is another tree. This is another tree. But all the trees are connected with a link to one another to make a final tree. And that binary tree is going to be treated as a binomial heap. Binomial heap. See, 12 is one tree, 10 with the 10 as a root node, that is another tree, with the 20 as root node, as another tree. But these tree has been connected with one another, That is called a binomial tree is all about. So what is binomial heap? Binomial heap is a heap with 12 nodes. It is a collection of 2 binomial trees of order 2 and 3 from left to right. So that is the idea here, with 2 binomial trees. So with the 10 as one node, also now that two things are connected. So what are the operations? Same operation, insert operation, you have to find, get the minimum element and extract minimum element, delete. So common operation is deletion and insertion. But other operation is finding the minimum, because we are dealing with minimum heap. we need to get the minimum element, we need to extract the minimum element, we need to decrease the key element like that, other varusidam. In addition to other operation, the major operation that finds a wonderful application with respect to binomial heap is union operation. So how to merge two binomial heap. So it is H1 is one binomial heap, and H2 is another. So union of H1 and H2 creates a single binomial. That is this one. This is one binomial heap. This is another binomial. So I want to merge all these things. I want to merge all these things. How to conduct this merge operation? That is the major task here. But this merging is very easier and it consumes very lesser time when compared with this is A. Is one head that is having the root as 12, 7, like this, and another is 83. Now, if I want to merge these two things, I need to maintain the property also. 12 should be merged with 18, then the 18 should comes to 7, then comes to 3, then only. So, this is merged. So, this is what the merge process is. So, when you are doing the merge process activity, again, it has to conduct the idea of the key. There are three graces, right? So if the order of the key is lesser, how to do it? If the order of key is greater, how to do about it? If the order of key is intermediate with the value of the branch, so how to extract it and how to put it in the correct way. So everything is discussed in these four cases in order to carry out the operations and in order to carry out the process. So if you go through it, you can easily find out. So now coming to the main picture, that is the Fibonacci key. So Fibonacci key is also a heap. But it is more powerful with respect to time consumption. That is, it consumes very lesser time when compared with the binary and the binomial queue, binomial heap. So these are the major operations. That is, find minimum, delete minimum, insert, decrease key, merge. But all the for all the operations, the Fibonacci heap maintains a minimum time. So what is the Fibonacci heap? It is also a collection of tree like binomial heap, but here, a tree of any shape can be taken into consideration, but there it's not the case. So binary heap is 80% similar to binomial heap is 80% similar to binary heap with small additional requirements. Whereas if you take the binomial heap, Fibonacci heap, Fibonacci almost 95% similar to binomial heap. But the thing is, you can have tree of any shape, even with a single node you can have, but that is not the case with the binomial heap. But you should have a pointer, and that pointer should point out the minimum element, and all the nodes in the first level, that is the level 0, that should be connected by using a circular linked list. So that's the idea. So here you have a point. All the tree roots, all tree roots can be connected using, so that all can be accepted using a single main pointer. So that is the major important breakthrough in terms of Fibonacci heaps, right? So this thing is not with the idea. So if you have used this idea, then what you can do is the merge operation is very simple. Even though merge operation is very simple in binomial heap, still the merge operation is very time effective one with respect to Fibonacci heap. So that's the idea. So you should have a pointer to point out the minimum element in the level, and you should have a circular linked list that maintains all the nodes of the level 0. So what you can find some interesting facts with respect to time complexity, but before that I have a difference with respect to binary heap, binomial heap, as well as the Fibonacci heap. For binary heap, you have the idea that is complete binary tree. You can have two keys, binary heap. This is what the example of min heap. That's what I explained using the slide. With respect to binomial heap, it's nothing but a collection of binomial trees. Even though it is a binomial tree, it also still follows the min heap property. So this is one tree and this is another tree, and it can be joined with the help of the link. And the difference between binary heap and binary is how the heaps are constructed. In binary heap, the heap is a single tree, which is a complete binary tree. The heap is a collection of smaller trees. That is, many smaller trees to form a binomial tree. A complete binary tree has to be built with respect to binary heap, but the joining or the merging of very smaller binary, smaller number of trees, that is to be treated as a binomial heap. What is Fibonacci heap? Fibonacci heap is like a binomial heap, but the tree can have any shapes. The tree can have any shapes, even if it is a small node tree, a one node tree, that is also acceptable. Like 23.7 here, and if you have a pointer, min pointer here, and if this the first nodes are kind of joined using circularly doubly linked list. Remember, circular doubly linked list. then you can easily identify the values when the this Fibonacci can be used for some advanced application. Also, when you take the operations with respect to insert, find, min, delete, decrease, key, union, these are the major operations with respect to heap. And if you find that the time consumption is very, very lesser in regard to Fibonacci heap, not like other heaps. See, when you look at it, binary heap sometimes better perform well. When you go for union operation, see, it is big O of n, that is very bigger time. When binary heap, that is big O of log n, that is very lesser time. And it is big O of n, very constant time with respect to Fibonacci. Likewise, you can find the major difference between the three different kinds of heaps. Right. So on the whole, if I want to summary, the order of the heap is binary heap is the bottom level. Over that, you have binomial heap, and over that, you have a Fibonacci heap. So that is what the idea. And all focus is to minimize the time consumption. Minimize the time consumption with respect to various operations that can be conducted using heap. So I will stop the lecture here. And let me go for some discussion.